Welcome to Calcast, your creator national podcast.
God Network News.
On events happening in our world today.
This is GNN.
This is God Network News, episode 108.
Welcome, GNN fans, to another episode of God Network News, the podcast that tells you what God's doing around the world, not what CNN tells you, but what GNN tells you is going on in the world. If you're tired of listening to all of that crisis network news and you want to hear what God's doing, well, give us a listen. Greetings, faithful God Network News fans and all you new listeners to God Network News. We're really excited to be bringing you fresh news from the field of what God's doing amongst unreached people group. And we want to thank you for all of you that listen to our series on the Middle East and all of the incredible stories and the comments that you gave. Please don't hesitate to put comments on our website and any questions you might have. And do visit those links that we have put in the show notes if you're interested in getting in contact with some of those interesting people that are behind the stories. And we want to start a whole new series, and this one is going to be very exciting. We've got tremendous amount of stories, fantastic, incredible stories of God's miracles from the continent of deep, dark Africa. Actually, it's not deep, dark Africa anymore, because about 60% of the population of that continent are now believers in Jesus. But there are still many unreached people groups there, and we've got a lot of workers that are doing incredible work amongst those remaining unreached people groups. And I hope that you will be inspired by all of these great stories from the continent of Africa.
So then the two guys that Abdallah evangelized, baptized them, and trained them, also they start other churches.
Oh my goodness, look at that's great.
Yeah, one of them, now we call him Jonathan, because also he was a Muslim man. So then he just changed his name. Now we call him Jonathan. So Jonathan went to a place called Tabora. It's a big region where thousands and thousands of people, I can say over a million people, they live in this area. So then Jonathan, he started a small church in the village that now he was living. Wow. So Jonathan, I just met Jonathan now 10 days ago in Tanzania. So he came to give us a report, some accountability about his job, and he started 13 different churches.
Wow, that's
and
amazing.
All the churches, each one has at least 20 people baptized.
Wow, that's
by
fantastic.
His life and by what God is doing through his life.
And are most of these people from a Muslim background?
The most of the people, they are from Muslim background.
Wow.
And not only Jonathan, but also the second one went to another place, and he started exactly 10 different churches just in villages among Muslim people, background, Muslim yeah. background, mm-hmm. but also pagan people, people without any religion.
Yeah.
This kind of people.
That's amazing.
So then we can see what God is doing through the life of someone that just started a job. Everything, of course, I can say that started through God's free life.
Yeah.
That God, he preached the gospel to Abdallah. So Abdallah became Christian follower of Jesus. So then he got training, he got new things from the Bible. So then he grew up in his spiritual life. So then he started to make other disciples.
Yeah, amen.
Yeah.
That's awesome, because that's really what this whole meeting is, that we're here at South Africa, is not just finding out about what God's doing, which is incredible. I mean, there's so many movements of not just multiplying disciples, but multiplied fellowships to the fourth and fifth and beyond generations.
Yes.
And they just, it's really under the Holy Spirit's control now.
Yes.
But it's all about discipling people who disciple other people.
Yes.
And oftentimes we make the mistake of thinking, oh, a disciple is just a Christian, right? And so we think, well, if people just become a Christian, that's good enough. But when you train them and you share with them, hey, one of the basic foundational things about being a believer is sharing your faith with others and seeing others come to the Lord and teaching them how to share.
Yeah.
And so it's a multiplication process that happens. And same with starting fellowships, right?
Yes.
So it's incredible what's happening amongst Muslims. I was actually just at another meeting just a couple of weeks ago, and there was a man there, two men that were talking about different movements amongst Muslims around the world. And they actually were looking at hundreds, literally hundreds of movements like this that are happening all over the world with Muslims, a very, very new thing. And they said today we can estimate approximately 25 million believers that are from a Muslim background,
yes,
believers in Jesus, now following Jesus. 25 million. That's incredible. Now, that's not a lot if you think about there being 1.7 billion Muslims, but it's still a lot, and it's still something to celebrate.
Yeah, for sure.
And Abdullah is one of those examples,
yes,
one of those,
yes,
brothers that just with the little bit he knew and studying the Word of God and growing in Jesus and sharing what he had,
yes,
with others that then shared,
yes,
it with others, it,
yes,
it grew.
And the good thing, Abdullah owes, he discipled his family because his firstborn, his first son,
yeah,
is taking care of a fellowship in the biggest city in Tanzania.
Okay.
And all the people that this boy is taking care, is preaching and teaching, this small fellowship, they came from Muslim background.
Yeah.
So then Abdullah made a great job.
Yeah, that's right. And also this is important because maybe Abdullah was working a lot with rural people, you know, people in the villages,
yes,
but now the young people, his son, are working with urban people,
yes,
in the cities and things, and that's great. That's just going to grow. Well, thank you so much for sharing this exciting first story with us,
yeah,
Paulo. We're so excited. I just want our God Network News fans to realize that God is on the move all over the world, working with unreached peoples, those who've never heard of Jesus before. They're hearing about Jesus and they're accepting him. They're embracing him as their Savior, their God. And it's incredible what the Lord's doing. But he's using us, isn't he, Paulo? He's,
yeah,
using us to do simple church, to teach, to not just lead people to the Lord, but say, now we need to pass that on to our friends and our family. If we love them, we want them to know the truth. But it's got to be simple, doesn't it? It can't be too complicated.
Yes, it's true. It's true.
So training them in simple church is so important. Okay, God Network News fan, that ends this episode. And I hope you will be praying for Paulo and the work that he's doing in Tanzania and all the others that are working, and with Abdullah and all of the others that were mentioned in the story. Please be praying for them. Thank you, Paulo, for coming.
Okay, thank you very much.
If you enjoyed this episode, please consider donating to help us continue to bring exciting stories fresh from the field. Visit our website at godnetworknews.com and select the PayPal link on the right side of the page, or consider becoming a Patreon partner to receive access to more valuable materials exclusive to our members.